So we were talking about jigsaw strategy. So home group, expert group, then again home group. I'll explain a little more well. So this is home group. 4 students or 6 students, we can give, we can do the grouping. So I have taken here also different activities. Here four students I give. This blue is a student. Maybe give a name, Fatima. Next is Mariam. Next is Sanu. Next is Anu. So 4 students sitting over there. So from biology I have taken one portion. Nucleus. Nucleus I have given there. So another group. Another, that means green color. Blue color I gave nucleus. Green color student I gave mitochondria, and red color student I gave cell wall, and yellow color student I gave protoplasm. So here the students, they have to learn themselves. Self-learning should happen. So there they can research on the topic, they can ask doubts to their group, but here self-learning is more important. So nucleus, she is trying to learn about nucleus. So mitochondria, the girl who got the topic mitochondria, she is trying to learn more about mitochondria. Cell wall, she is trying to learn more about that. Then protoplasm, the girl who got that, she is also trying to learn more about that. Then after that, we are going to separate those home group to expert group. So expert group, here all the students who got nucleus in the class will sit together. Then all the students who got mitochondria in the class will sit together. Then all the students who got cell wall will sit together. All the students who got protoplasm will sit together. So here, this is expertise group. They expertise the material. So their arguments will be there. Their teaching, cooperative teaching will be there. They will understand more well, and they will learn here, and they will expertise themselves with the topic. Then they have to move to the home group again. So here in this group, they have to teach each other. So nucleus, she is already expertised with the topic. So she will teach everything related to that to her group members, and mitochondria, the same way teaching will happen. Cell wall, the same way will happen. Protoplasm, again, the teaching will happen over there. Here, the students are teaching each other. So the students are teachers here. Then after that, we teachers, we want to know whether the students learned something or not. Here we can give assessment. So after that, we are giving assessment to the students. It can be a quiz form, or we can ask questions. We can have a class discussion. So nucleus, the girl who got nucleus will say, I learned this topic more from her. I learned this topic more from the third group. She told me very well about that. She explained me very well about that. So this is learning. They are doing it themselves, and they are learners. They are teachers. Everything happens among the students. So next is WEBS. Depth of knowledge. This is another strategy which can be used in the classroom. It was developed by Norman Webb in 1997. So level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. So level 1, recall. Level 2, basic application of skill and concept. Level 3, strategic thinking. And level 4, extended thinking. So level 1, students will identify essential information needed to accomplish a task. Level 2, students will identify information in a passage that is supported by facts. Then level 3, students will identify appropriateness of an argument using supportive evidence. Level 4, students will identify interrelationships, themes, ideas, concepts developed in more than one literary work. So here also I have given one example from geography. Identify the properties of a rock. That is for level 1. Level 2, describe the difference between a rock and a mineral and give an example of each. Then level 3, of the 4 rocks you are working with, determine which one contains mineral calcite. Then support your claims with evidence from your investigation. So strategic thinking. Next, extended thinking. Design a model that will show how rocks can be changed and related to another cycle. Be prepared to share with your classmates. This is another strategy which can be given in the classroom. Web's depth of knowledge. Next, exit entry tweet slips. These are developed by Fisher and Frey in 2004. Entry tickets. Entry exit strategy helps students to summarize and reflect on information learned. Entry tickets focus students' attention on the day's topic or ask students to recall background knowledge beginning of a lesson. Then exit slips, entry tickets should be given at the beginning of a class. So exit slip, end of the class. Exit slips give students an opportunity to review key ideas, consider essential details, and summarize thinking. Then end of the lesson only we should give this exit slips. So this entry exit slips can be in this format. The most important thing I learned today, I didn't understand. So the teacher can go back to the class and explain the students what she couldn't understand. Then the most important thing I learned today, we will understand whether the student has learned the key concept or whether she has achieved learning objectives. Then summarize the main points of today's lesson in 10 words. Think. What do you think about the next part of the topic? So we are asking the students to think. Next, tweet. Lesson tweet. Tweet slip. This definitely the students will like because they want to tweet things, you know. So how to do it? After taking the class, I have given here Twitter bird. So at to the student, at Mariam. Then childhood class 1, childhood 1. This is a poem from grade 11. Okay. Childhood class 1, childhood 1. So second class, childhood 2. That is tweet slip. So World War class 1, the first class, tweet World War 1. Then second class, World War 1, 2. So World War 1, 1, World War 1, 2. Then the third class, World War 1, 3. So this way we have to give, hashtag should be given like that. So questions, we can give different questions. Something I learned today, I wish to know more about this and the question I have. Different questions can be given by the teacher. Next is ticket out the door. The most important thing I learned today. The question about what I have learned today. This is ticket out the door. This is exit slip. And this is another a ticket in the door. How did you complete your homework? So this is we are giving beginning of the class. How did you complete your homework? List key ideas you remember from your previous day lesson. So we are checking the previous knowledge of the students through this. Next, sample exit slip. For smaller class students, how do you feel about today's session? If they are happy, they will tick the happy smiley. And why? If they are not so happy, we can ask what happened or what was the reason. So we can find out about the class also. This is how the teacher's reflection also can be taken from this. Next, think and share technique. So think, how to use? Think, pair, share. We will ask the students to think about something. So when they think, we have to tell the students to note down, write down your thinking. What have you thought about the topic? Write down. Then you pair. Pair means then they have to pair, speak each other. Then they have to share in the class what they have thought and what they have shared in the, that means their discussions. From the pair, what did they discuss? So that they have to share in the classroom. That is think, pair, and share. This is a format for think, pair, and share. Write 3 points you have about this question or problem. Then pair, discuss your ideas with your partner. Share it in the classroom. Next, for maths and science class, we can use this. It can be used for feedback assessment strategy. when they are doing maths problem, if they're stuck, they can show, ma'am, I am stuck. Instead of, ma'am, come here, ma'am, please, I am stuck. They can show this card, red card. That means the teacher will come to know the child wants to get some assistance from the teacher. The next one, I need some help. That means somehow she could manage, but she needs some help. I understand it. I have got this. I am very perfect with this. So that means we will understand the green card holders. They are very thorough with the portion. And the yellow card, we can give little more attention for them. Red card, definitely we have to sit with them to make them learn. And next is KWL chart. K, what I know. W, what I want to know. L, what I learned. This also will be given at the beginning of the class. Write what you already know about the topic. This is checking of previous knowledge. Then write what you want to know about the topic, expectation of the teacher. Then at the end of the class, write what you have learned. So we will understand whether the student has learned from the class. Next is a learning contract. So learning contract is a written agreement between teachers and students. What students will learn, how they will learn it, the time period for the learning experience, and how they will be evaluated, it can be given in the learning contract. So this is a learning contract template, objective for your assignment. When we are giving assignment, we can give this learning contract also. Some students will complain, all the teachers have given all the works together, we are not able to do it on time, and all such complaints will be there. Even parents also will complain at sometimes like that. So we can use this learning contract for such situation. So we are giving two or three questions or assignments, then we are giving time for completion. So 1 week, for example, 1 week, if you are giving, after the first day, the student should come and get the signature from the teacher. That means the first task she has completed. And the second day, second task. And the third day, third task. Or we can give duty to a leader also in the classroom to check that. That means the students are doing the activity in a time bound or a time bound period. So that is the benefit of this learning contract. So optional activities to extend your learning are also can be attached along with this learning contract. So presentation, how do we present it? It can be discussion, questioning, read aloud, verbal description by the students, then show it, pictures, graphic organizers, whiteboard, film, video clip, then model it, demonstrate. It's not think aloud, not talk, think aloud, then act out, build, construct, use manipulatives. Next is differentiating assessment. So pen paper test can be given, quiz, online quiz, performance assessment, lesson task activities, student self-assessment, observation rubrics, then peer assessment, questioning, portfolio. Portfolio also can be given. This is a site for portfolio actually. This will be very useful for teachers. Yes, authentic assessment tools. For portfolio, this will be really useful for teachers. So pre-assessment, formative assessment, summative assessment. We can give different types of assessment. Ongoing assessment, feedback. Feedback is very important for the students and for the teachers also. Self and peer assessment also can be given. Assessment for learning, that is very important. Assessment for learning and assessment as learning, both are very important for assessment of learning. So next is power of feedback. So Hattie's model can be used for the feedback. Feed up, where am I going? Feedback, how am I going? And feed forward, where to next? Usually we teachers give feed forward, where to go next. That means self level. Well done, very good, wonderful work. No, we have to give feed up, that means is the work correct, what are the, you know, changes that the student should do in the work, that is feed up. Then feedback, we have process level, the process used to complete the task. Next, confidence to engage further with the task. And the last level is well done. That means feed forward will come at the last. Usually teachers give this only one feedback, that is well done or very good. It should be from the feed up, feedback, feed forward. Feed up and feedback for the students to improve themselves. Okay. Self feedback, peer feedback, teacher feedback. There are different graphic organizers to give this. I didn't include that in this actually. And today or this lesson or this week, whether I stayed on the task, this is self-assessment. Use a quiet voice, listened to others, helped others, worked independently, or I wandered around in the class, used a loud voice, ignored others, told others what to do, bossy, distracted others, worked cooperatively. So I worked cooperatively for this task. I shared resources. I met deadlines. So my self-feedback is very good. I prepared to share, hoped resources, left task incomplete. So the student should feel that they have to improve next time. I am positive about what I can do. I asked questions when I needed. Oh, I am negative about what I can't do. Thought about how I worked. So next time I should improve. The student should feel that they have to improve next time. So this also can be given in the classroom. So this is the classroom which we want. Differentiated learning, gamification, art integrated activities, project-based learning, competency-based learning, and this will give you by the introduction of NEP in the classroom. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. That was a wonderful session, something very unique and something which, I mean, a lot of techniques you have told and really, I mean, how the time flew, we didn't know. So we'll take up a few questions. Anybody wants to, not only questions, if somebody wants to share or add something, we'll be taking up those questions and also the feedback. And ma'am also wanted to, you know, you wanted to send a feedback form, ma'am, you can do that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, in the meantime, if somebody wants to ask any question or if they want to share something, you are most welcome to go ahead. So we'll be having many more sessions coming up, and all the AIF core members and the resource people are requested to, you know, come forward and organize more and more webinars, because as I told you, AIF is your platform. So please don't hesitate. Whenever you have something to share, please do get in touch with me. And we are there to learn from each other. So nobody is an expert and everybody is an expert, if you take it that way. So the learning process is very mutual. So I would encourage people to, you know, speak up and come forward, and as and when you get time, that is, I mean, priority I would say is always school and family, but whenever you get time, please try to take out some time for this also. So any Thank questions you, or anything you would like to share, please go ahead.
Sir, I posted the
okay, you know, so feedback the link form. Posted,
so ma'am. Teachers, I'll be grateful if you could fill up this
ma'am feedback wanted form. Yeah, she has given
so it is a feed forward for me also.
Absolutely. That's a great thing to get always a feedback of the sessions.
Yeah, certainly. I would like to mention, may I, sir? Matthew, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Meenakshi, ma'am, please.
Hello. Thanks a lot for this wonderful session, ma'am. It was indeed wonderful. And though many of the strategies I have already been using in my school and to teach various age groups, you see, there are different modifications as per the age level. If we're starting from the primary to the same strategy is done in a different manner. And this was something very new for me, this feed forward. And I really liked it a lot.
Actually, ma'am, there is another session. We should organize another session along with some NEP programs, sir, because feedback, power of feedback, another, it is there. It is, it can be taken as another session, actually. It is a lot to, you know, contribute in that. And there are different...
yes, sir. Any resource material that you are having, you are most welcome to share with the...
Yes, sir, I have. Yeah. Definitely, so, I will.
You know, because sometimes one idea is enough for people to begin the work. You know, that so that, you know, at least, you know, some people who are who have no idea at all, they can go through it. And, you know, some take enough because, you know, all of us are educators. We read a lot. We go through different stuff. So some ideas sometimes help. So, of course, as a webinar in itself, if you have the time and others have time, is always good. But in the meantime, if some resources can be shared, that will be great.
Thank you, sir.
Especially, sir, I'm Shweta this side. Can I ask something?
Please.
Yeah, especially if there are some relevant sites, as ma'am had been telling us strategies and there were sites mentioned at the bottom. So if there are some sites for some feedbacks or some kind of strategy, that will help us learn that particular strategy in depth. Because in a webinar, the introduction is done.
Yes.
So to use it in depth, yeah. If we have that, then it will help us more.
Yeah, sir, actually I have the materials of this, some resource materials I have. I don't know how to share it.
Ma'am, you can share the websites, as Shweta ma'am has said. If she wanted to know more about the websites that you were referring to.
If she could contact me personally, I could share that.
Yeah, yeah. So
I can share the materials. Actually, downloaded the materials.
You are having her number, actually. Her number is in the group. Her number is in as the admin. So you can directly contact her through WhatsApp.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Anything, anyone else wants to share anything? Dimple ma'am, Annie ma'am, Ritika ma'am, any comments?
Sir, okay. Fill the form, feedback form, and submit.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
I think we are filling the feedback form. I have sent it also to you.
Thank you, ma'am.
So the recording will be available, as I said, the first, it will be in two parts. The first part I have already sent in the group. So if anybody has missed out any portions, they can have a view. So as soon as the meeting gets over, I will be sending you the second part.